I'm here at Dr. Lee's office today. I'm coming all the way from Philadelphia. I absolutely hate flying. It's terrifying. I'm afraid of heights. So I really hope that I can fix whatever's going on here.
Jennifer?
Hello.
Hi. If Dr. Lee can't help me today, I'll be absolutely devastated. I've made this huge trip, and I really would be heartbroken if it was all for nothing.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm all right,
good.
I guess.
Good. I'm Dr. Lee. It's really nice to meet you. Aren't you cute? I love your hair.
Oh, thank you.
You have these bumps here on your ears. I bet that's not part of the hairstyle, is
it? No, it's not intentional, no.
Yeah? How long have you had these?
Like 11 years. Okay. They make me very dizzy.
Do you know what these are?
I'm not sure.
You're not sure? They look like keloids to me. Did you have your ears pierced when you were a kid?
Yes.
Oh my goodness, this is heavy.
Yeah.
Keloids are like an overgrowth of scar tissue. It's just as if like these fibroblasts, these are the cells that create collagen or scar tissue. They just get revved up and very excited. Jennifer has some extreme keloids. They are really heavy and I can't imagine walking around with these weights. Probably the largest thing that I've ever seen. One of the issues that I noticed right away is that they are attached to a significant portion of her ear, and that is something that is concerning to me. This is the dilemma with keloids. The fact is that they're created by trauma. You know, you had piercings so that created surgery to remove something is a trauma. So the risk is that you remove a keloid and it just comes back again and it comes back bigger. This is the one that I'm more concerned about in terms of actually removing it successfully because I'm concerned that it's traveling through your ear. You know, the thing is we need to try to remove as best we can all the keloidal tissue. So hopefully we can just close that side by side. But is it going all the way through, you know, to the other side? Is there solid keloid tissue from one side to the other? If that is, we might have to close it and kind of, it might subtly change the shape of your ear a little bit.
One of the things that I look at carefully to decide whether a keloid can be successfully removed is how attached it is to normal skin. Jennifer's keloids are more sessile, meaning they're more attached to a wider base on her ear. And that is concerning to me because that does mean that there's a higher chance that they can recur. I think that there's a chance we could remove this successfully and have them not return.
We want to get the ear to look as normal as we can, but I've had patients had to remove most of their ear from skin cancer or things, but I've actually purposely kept the top of their ear so that they could put their glasses on.
So when I'm doing a surgery to remove large keloids in the ear, sometimes you have to sacrifice part of the normal ear. I think it's important to explain to the patient that once we do that, there's no turning back. You can't just poof, make them disappear and you have this normal ear again. And the patient has to understand that she may not really get the ear that she used to have before the keloids were there.
I'm a little scared, I'm anxious.
Mm-hmm. Of course, that's understandable. That's totally understandable and you know that.
Change is difficult. Even if it's something that you know you want or that you know you need, you have to be prepared to like accept it no matter what it is. Because once they're gone, there's no going back.
I would be anxious in the same position that you are in. Are you okay with us continuing?
All right, I think I'm okay.
All right, we'll make sure you're nice and comfortable, okay? We'll get all set up and we'll see you in a little bit, all right? Okay. Okay, put a little numbing right there.
Needles are not my friend.
Okay, one little baby pinch, or just a baby pinch, pinch.
Baby pinch. That's it.
So what do you like to do in your spare time?
I like to cosplay.
Sounds like fun.
I can be a chatterbox. I like to talk to my patients and get to know them. And in this case, I use it to my advantage because it helps to calm the nerves of my patients if you get them thinking and talking about other things and what's going on. And I think in this case, it's working.
Okay. You should not feel anything other than us touching you, okay?
All right.
Just taking this little friend of yours off
and keep as much of your normal ear as I can here.
I can hear it scraping.
Yes,
that's so crazy.
Whenever I work on people's head, their scalp, or their ears in particular, the sound is amplified. You know, even if you kind of scratch your ear, you can hear yourself doing that inside too. You can hear that in your head, and sometimes that can freak people out. I don't want this to come back, but I also don't want to increase the trauma here. There's a lot of factors I'm thinking about here. Guess what? He's gone. I removed the largest of the 4 keloids. It was probably the largest that I've ever removed. And I was surprised at how much it was actually attached to her ear. So I unfortunately had to take off more of the normal ear than I expected. The key is like to have them not own you. You own them. And now there's time to go. Rent is up. Guess what? It's out of you. Both of the keloids on Jennifer's left ear are now gone, but that was actually the easy part. I realize now that I've had to traumatize a good surface area of Jennifer's ears, and so what am I gonna do to try to fix this up? Because keloids are created by trauma, and the more that I traumatize the skin, the higher the risk is of a keloid growing back. All right, let's hope this one's nicer to me.
This one is my oldest one.
Yeah. Better not be the grumpy one. These are really more attached than I imagined. In fact, this one on her right ear may be going all the way through to the other side. I mean, it's affecting the helical rim, it's affecting the anti-helix, and I'm afraid that it's gonna go clear through the ear from one side to the other. And that would be trouble if she had a big hole in her ear. I have no normal skin to patch that up.
We gotta take out some of this tissue under here.
See, because we normally have cartilage there anyway, so that is what we know is normally there, but sometimes it's hard to discern. That is ready. Tuck something under there. That looks good, actually. Luckily, this keloid did not go through her ear. Because it was 2 separate ones, I could remove it and still maintain this general shape of her ear. But now she's left with an area that has to heal by secondary intent, meaning letting it heal from the underside and from the sides, and slowly these new skin cells are gonna grow and cover that area. It's gonna take a few months, but it will get there. This is the issue that I have right here. I might need to do like a little graft right there of tissue from this tissue that I removed on you. I gotta just recreate your ear here.
Sometimes when you want to successfully close a wound, you need to do a graft. A graft is when you take tissue from somewhere else in the body, completely detach it, but then use it to patch up another area. And in this case, that's what we're doing. And I think that's really important in Jennifer's case on her left ear, because we want to maintain the shape of her normal earlobe. If I somehow distort her helical rim, which is that outside edge of her earlobe, it's much more noticeable.
Let's show it to you. Let me tilt you up a little bit more.
Okay.
This was a really complicated, very challenging and intricate surgery, and I'm still worried about the amount of trauma that I've created on her ear, but I know she's gonna be really pleased with the results.
All right, we're gonna give you a mirror here, okay?
Oh my God.
They're gone though. That makes a huge difference, girlfriend.
I feel like half my face is missing.
It took up half your face. You look amazing. But you're okay with that? See how that ear's a little smaller?
Yeah, I see it. It's
actually really cute.
I kind of like it.
Yeah. I agree. I think if anyone's gonna like it, you're gonna accept it.
Just seeing myself without the keloid, it's just made me. I forgot what I looked like. I forgot that I could feel so good about myself. I can't believe it's gone. It's so crazy. I probably haven't been this happy in like probably 15 years. I actually feel like I'm really confident. Like I feel like I could take on the world.
Let's see how much they weigh. 14 ounces, pretty much.
Jeez. I love it. I actually do. I really like it.
Yes.